In the last video, we talked about hyperscalers and what kind of bets they're making to win that AI race.
But today, we are covering big names in the consumer space: Tesla, Meta, and Apple.
Ooh, such different companies. What links them all? AI.
And they are hungry to win the AI battle. So let's find out how. I'm Bertrand Seguin, and I'm the founder of App Economy Insights.
And I'm Stephanie Wong, tech veteran, engineer, and creator. If you remember last time, we talked about the tech AI stack. Most hyperscalers have their paws in almost every part of the stack. Tesla, Meta, and Apple don't have a big B2B cloud computing arm yet.
Right. So what kind of AI are they doing?
Tesla is using and creating advanced AI for vision and planning, but their business model looks a lot different than Microsoft, Google, and Amazon. When it comes to the AI tech stack, they're focusing on everything from chip to car. First off, there's Autopilot, which you all know allows cars to steer, accelerate, and brake automatically in the lane. All new Tesla cars since 2016 come with Autopilot. Tesla is also working on AI-integrated chips, so cars can navigate through freeways and even traffic. They claim that Tesla chips are 21 times faster than the original NVIDIA chips and 20% cheaper too. Tesla discussed in 2022 how they can lend their Dojo superchip to other companies for AI training, similar to cloud providers. They're working on deep neural networks for problems ranging from perception to control. If they're able to achieve fully self-driving cars, they've talked about launching a robot taxi service like Airbnb and Uber combined. They're even working on a Tesla bot, a humanoid robot capable of performing tasks that are unsafe, repetitive, or boring. And Elon says that this plus self-driving cars could change the business model of the company entirely.
Tesla didn't turn a profit until 2019 and mostly survived on selling its emission credits. A big play in cloud computing could more than replace Tesla's revenue from selling carbon credits. It's a multi-billion dollar market. In Q4 2022, full self-driving alone made more than $300 million in revenue, almost as much as the regulatory credit. And it's a high-margin business. But Tesla often discusses products that are years away from being market-ready in order to recruit talent and build hype. The company has a long way to go before full self-driving is a reality for all of us.
I think Tesla has suffered from a few distractions lately, and if they are to win this AI race, they are going to need to put the pedal to the metal.
I see what you did there.
Yes. Before we go any further, remember to hit that subscribe button so we can keep bringing you free content and help you on your tech, business, and investing journey. Next, we have Meta. Meta has been using AI to help target ads on their platform for years. They have been active in a few parts of the AI tech stack. First off, they have released open source developer tools like PyTorch. They have also researched and made progress with closed source models like Cicero. This AI is so advanced that it wins at diplomacy, a complex strategy game. They've also built AI into their products, like using AI to moderate content or detect harmful misinformation. They're building AI into the metaverse and hardware efforts like BuilderBot. This lets people generate or import things into the virtual world just by using voice commands. And now they're working on generative AI research. For instance, text that can convert a text prompt into a video clip.
New emerging platforms like TikTok and Apple's end-to-end app tracking transparency have eroded Meta's defensible moat. So now the company needs AI to improve its retention and ad conversion. To combat ATT, Meta's building probabilistic ML models that not only figure out who should be targeted, but also understanding which ads converted or not. This will also be essential to Instagram Reels' continued growth to keep up with TikTok.
The challenge is these models will be built by massive fleets of GPUs, which are pricey. In the long run, though, this investment should pay off for a number of reasons. One, content and ad targeting will restart their revenue growth. Two, once these AI data centers are built out, the cost to maintain them should be significantly less than the first time. And three, this massive investment is one that no other company in that space can make, except for maybe Google.
ATT hurt Meta more than any other company. because it already had by far the largest and most finely tuned ad business. But in the long run, Meta could turn things around. All right, next we have Apple. ML and AI is intertwined in nearly every feature of the iPhone. But Apple hasn't been touting these technologies like some of its competitors have. If you're an Apple user, you've definitely interacted with their AI every day. They focus primarily on end-to-end apps. Let's mention five of them. The first one is day-to-day features like language translation, on-device dictation, features around health and sleep, blurring your portrait mode, for example, in photo backgrounds. Then we have accessibility features, like sound detection capabilities for the hearing impaired. Number three, we have their built-in assistant that you all know, Siri. It uses natural language processing and voice recognition. Number four is Face ID. It leveraged AI-based image detection and computer vision technology to enable, you know, unlocking your phone. And number five, they are feeding into the generative AI hype. They released optimizations that allows Stable Diffusion to run on Apple Silicon using Core ML, Apple's framework for ML models. Stable Diffusion is already an impressively small model that could run on an iPhone. And now, Apple's optimizations allow developers to use Apple Neural Engine hardware to run Stable Diffusion about twice as fast as the previous Mac-based method. It's a smart play that reflects Apple's integrated model.
Look, this is only the beginning. While Apple has been shipping its Neural Engine on its own chips for years, it seems pretty likely that future Apple chips will be tuned for Stable Diffusion. Just like the other big tech companies, their success is going to depend on how well they can vertically integrate AI into their own tech stack from chip to software. They need to capture day-to-day consumers to get things done more easily using Apple products, and even the ML developers to run ML workloads on their hardware.
You know, just thinking about the amount of AI processing going on right now in the palm of my hand feels pretty neat.
Okay, look, I'm not so sure how useful a humanoid robot will be anytime soon, or whether I'm that excited about better targeted ads on Facebook or Instagram, but from a purely business perspective, AI isn't just a nice to have. It's pretty essential for these companies' pure existence in the long term.
Yep, and we still have one more video in this three-part series where we'll be covering quite possibly the biggest winners in AI so far, semiconductors.
Yeah, sounds semi-sexy. I mean, not really.
Well, but they are the picks and shovels in the gold rush.
True. Well, comment below with your thoughts and predictions and subscribe for more videos from us to help you with your tech, business, and investing journey.